So in this class, we're going to talk about three main kinds of inferential statistics. Remember, these inferential statistics are when you make inferences about populations based on samples, on sample data. Notice if you measure everybody in the population, you don't have a sample. If you've done a census, then you don't even need inferential statistics. You have all the information that you need. So all these inferential statistics are about using sample data to make inferences about populations. All right, the first kind of inferential statistic I want to talk about is called a point estimate. And for these, you guess a population parameter. Remember, so these are just descriptive statistics of populations, means, standard deviations, things like that. So for a point estimate, you guess a population parameter based on a sample statistic. All right, so for example, if we're trying to figure out the average intelligence of SUU students, and we have a sample, and we measure their intelligence, and the average of that sample's intelligence is 110, then we can use this as our best guess at the average intelligence of all SUU students, which would be a population parameter. So we would just, we would guess that the SUU students' population mean IQ is 110. The second kind of inferential statistics I want to talk about are called confidence intervals. And these are plausible, it's a plausible range of values for a population parameter. And this is going to be centered around a point estimate. And that range of plausible values is going to be mathematically determined with some probability statistics that we'll talk about pretty soon in this class. But these are something that you often see when it is time for presidential elections, where they'll say a margin of error in the polling. And a margin of error is a confidence interval, so plus or minus 5 percentage points for President Trump. That would be a margin of error. Or in this case, what we might have is something like our guess is that the population average IQ for SU students is 110 plus or minus 5 IQ points. It doesn't actually quite look like that, but that's generally the idea of how these confidence intervals would look. And in this class, we're going to do a lot of point estimates. Those are a frequent part of doing inferential statistics. They're a subcomponent for the last kind. Actually, maybe I'll come back and talk about that at the end. Okay, and the third main kind of inferential statistic that we're going to talk about in this class is called hypothesis testing. In here, you see if your sample data support your research question, your research hypothesis. That is about a state of the world, so this is about a population, but you just look at a sample to see if the sample is consistent with your hypothesis or not. Here, for example, you might have a research hypothesis that caffeine increases attention. So you could do an experiment, you could give some participants caffeinated coffee, other participants decaffeinated coffee, measure their attention. And if the caffeinated group has higher attention than the decaf group, you would say that your sample data supports the conclusion that caffeine increases attention in the population. All right, and this is the focus of the second half, the rest of this class. And you could, and this would count as applied statistics. This isn't theoretical. This is applying statistics to make decisions about the world. Okay. All right, so in this class, point estimates are something that we often do as part of hypothesis testing. So point estimates are going to be a very common thing that we do. Confidence intervals are a topic that we're going to focus on just for one day so that you understand how they work and therefore how to interpret them when you see them in a research article, or how you could produce them if you needed to later on in your own research. But we're not going to do confidence intervals for every statistical test that we talk about, even though we could do that. It's just not worth the time. So we'll introduce these conceptually, and then that's all we'll do with confidence intervals in this class. But from this point on in the class, we're really going to focus on these hypothesis testing inferential statistics. And there's a whole bunch of different ones depending on the scales of measure of your variables, and we're going to work through a lot of different kinds of these.